Pierre, you want to come out here?
What is poppin'? Greetings to YC Nation. Hope everyone had a wonderful day. Now today, let's discuss, let's talk, let's react, let's analyze basically, man, what happened between the last match between the United States, man, and Mexico. Now, there's a lot to talk about, a lot to analyze, a lot to digest, a lot to discuss. So basically, first, let's talk a little bit about the both starting 11s for both teams, okay? Then watch the video, see what happened, because I know the result, okay? But I don't know how the goals were scored, okay? Basically, I haven't watched the game, so it was like in 3 or 4 in the morning for me, so that's too late, basically. Let's do that, and also talk about, I've seen that there was some controversial plays, you know, some arguments or discussions, whatever, you know, as you can see here in the photo, there were 3 red cards, you know, in this match, so let's talk about that also, see what happened. So basically, United States, they line up, man, with Matt Turner in goal. Okay, I accept that, yes, right now I'll say he's our best keeper, but soon or in the future, it will be Gaga Sonina, trust me. On the right side, we have Serginho Dest, who received a red flag, so we have to see what happened later, man. I mean, if you ask me, that's a little bit reckless and stupid, because take into account that you gotta play one more match against Canada in order to win this. Because if you don't know, Canada already defeated Panama, so... Anyway, Miles Robinson and Chris Richards. Now, I think that's a good partnership. Me, in the future, I would like to see CCV and Chris Richards. I think that would be our best partnership in the back. Anthony, you know, Jedi Robinson, right? As a left back, I mean, there's no one else, so yes. Yunus Musa in the middle with Weston McKennie. He also received a red flag. That's good. No Tyler Adams, so okay. I like this change of formation. Timothy Weah, aka the Panther, on the right. Giovanni Reyna as a 10, okay. Captain America, and also he got a brace, so oof, man, oof. Okay, very interesting. And Florian Balogun made his start, okay. One thing I gotta say about Balogun, if you check my videos from the past, I've always wanted him as a striker, I always talked about that he should be our striker. The thing is, the only thing that makes me, you know, feel a little bit bad is, you know, for me, he has to prove himself and earn my respect, because if you know, man, in the beginning, initially, he was more declined, right, or more, estaba más decantado towards playing for England, you know what I mean? And I don't like that, because it makes me feel like, you know, he's just another British reject, you know me, that we've taken into our squad, you know me, and that's not good either. I mean, still, you know, that's why he's gonna have to earn my respect, you know, and show himself, prove himself, because I don't really like that, you know me. I don't really like that, because initially he always had, you know, he was trying to play for England, you know, England on paper they're the better national team, right? So you may have more success with them, or whatever, but you know they have a locked in 9, who's Harry Kane. So more likely he wouldn't play, you know, until Harry Kane retires, and there's still time for that. So I thought, you know, United States is basically the plan B. That's what I think he saw us like, you know, in the end he came with us. But anyway, okay, let's put that to a side, you know, and move on. So Mexico, man, the lineup with, now guys that I know are Pineda, I know him, ex-Celta, I think now he plays in somewhere in Europe, no? In Greece maybe? I don't know, I'm not sure, but I know him. Jorge Sanchez also, the right back, plays for Ajax. Never watched these two. Well, Pineda, yes, I've seen him with Celta. Chavez in the middle, I know him too. He scored a free kick or a long shot, right, in the World Cup. It was a pretty good goal. Edson Alvarez, of course, Ajax also. Cesar Montes, actually plays now with Espanyol. Also received a red flag, wow. And Guillermo Ochoa in goal. Now, substitutes, we have Waco Zimmerman, I still don't know why he's in the team, but okay. Ricardo Pepi, very good. Brendan Aronson. Luca de la Torre. Joe Scully, okay. What disappoints me is that no Cardoso, no minutes for Cardoso, man. No minutes for Señora, 2 players I want to see. Also Zendejas, man, he could have played. I mean, hubiera estado caliente, you know, que juegue Zendejas, porque sabes que él es mexicano y estoniense. Anyway, man, then Mexico substituted Gerardo Arteaga. I know him. He plays for Genk in the Belgium league. Good player. He received a red flag also. We have to see that. Santi Jimenez. He plays for Feyenoord. Now, I don't know why he doesn't start for Mexico, man. I mean, he's the most informed striker right now. So, And also, I know Julian Araujo, you know, ex-Galaxy, currently plays for Barcelona. Alexis Vega, also know him. He plays for Guadalajara, if I'm not wrong. So, and also on FIFA, he has a you know, real game face. So, anyway, man, those are the lineups, man. So it's time, let's watch, man. Let's see what happened in this match.
Woo! Okay, hombre, que es una fiesta esto.
So, Nation League's Concacaf semifinal. And also, man, there's one or two things I gotta say also about the match. I'll say at the end of this, you know, of the highlights. It's more about Mexico, you know, than about the United States. Bueno, it's one thing about Mexico, one thing about United States. Oh, look at Gio Reyna, man. He's trying to be like an Argentine player or what? And Brazilian, so what? Dye his hair blonde. New look. Okay.
Boom. Boom. Boom.
Okay. I'm very intrigued to watch Gio Reyna, man. United States. Vale? Qué buen comienzo, ¿no? Ah, bueno, pasa nada. Vale. The United States have more shots than Mexico and more possession, but still, man, I want to see good chances for Mexico. You mean? I want to see that was a, you know, a contested match. I want to see them going, you know, blow for blow. Mm, bueno, okay, vale, okay. Bien ahí, Matt Turner, very good. That was a good pass, maybe offside, but very good for Matt Turner coming off for yes. Serginho. La Panza. Ok. Gio. Ok. Well, actually, that was weak, man. I don't know why that's in the highlights, but. Ok. La Panza. Vale. Serginho. Serginho. Ok. Ok. Vale. Sigan. Vale. Vale. Panza. Ah, man, I think they stretch out this video too much because I mean this is not a play. Nothing really happened. You mean that's dangerous. Captain America, the pace, you gone. Oh, madre mía, tío, qué jugada, tío. I always say, man. Oh my goodness, what a goal from Peterson, man. Oof, now look at this, the pace, man, big run, man, number four, man, oof, man, that looks bad, you mean, I mean, oof, that looks really bad, let me ask the mind, me attack, the dribble, oh, man, the finishing, Pulisic, man, that's something, oh, man, that's something I, you know, that kills me about him, man, the finishing, man, how is that now on goal, man, how is this now on goal, look at this, the dribble is the keeper, okay, and now here, it's really difficult because the keeper's on it. But regardless, man, come on, man. Pulisic, tío. Está infiltrado este, ¿eh? Aquí con los mexicanos. That's really good, you know. It's so that we have... Madre mía, Pulisic, qué peso frío es, tío. Me cago en, cabrón.
Y después lo más lo que parecía más fácil se le complica.
I mean, one thing about Pulisic, man, he has 30 composure, man. Y creo que between 30 and 20 composure, man. It hurts, you mean, but it's a fact. I mean, you gotta see the obvious, man. I could be impartial or biased, or how you say. Bueno. Guillermo Ochoa. 37 años. Uf, 47 years of age. Eh? Mexico, I'm sorry, but you gotta start thinking about replacement because he ain't gonna be there forever. Vale. Serginho. Okay. Mua. Vaya cagada la defensa de México.
Estados Unidos. Otra vez Cristian Pulisic.
Vaya cagada aquí. No despejan el balón. Mira, uff. ¿Jugó da Jorge Sánchez?
Otra vez Cristian Pulisic. Error en la salida.
This guy right here. This guy right here. Look, this right here. Very bad, man. No control. Jorge Sánchez, right? Buff. I agree with that commentator. It was a gift.
Yes.
Sánchez, you gotta pay more attention. You either gotta clear that one time or try to control it better. You mean? I mean, you can't lose control of the ball like that in the box. You mean? Okay, Pulisic, man, chill out, man. I mean, I understand, you know, what it means, Coca Mexico and stuff like that, man. But Santa, I think they over, you know, you get overhyped, man. He's acting there, you know, like he scored a goal in the semifinals of the World Cup, man. Also, take into account, I downplay a lot of times, you know, this tournament and all these matches because, you know, I come from watching Real Madrid, Barcelona, Premier League, you know, Liga Santander, UEFA Champions League, Europa League, Conference League. So, you know, when I see this, it's not the same level, you know what I mean? It doesn't mean the same. Okay! Connection well, Pulisic! And that is 2-0, okay. Very good. Man, where is key, man? I don't know, I don't understand people, man. When I see a lot of times online, on Instagram and stuff like that, you know, when I see it on posts, people saying that, you know, always saying that Reyna should be the starter, and, you know, the starter on the right side, on the right wing, and stuff like that. And they always bench where? Or a lot of times I hear guys like Alexi Lalas, no, who, I don't even know what his name is, man. And commentators like that, man, they always say the starting 11, they never include where in there, man. Like, are you crazy or what, man? Where's Crucial, man, for our attacking? I mean, ain't nobody attacks from the right side like he does, man. Balogun, man, 62 minutes into the match. The only thing I've seen from you so far is a foul. But we ain't gonna bash him, you know, heavily criticize him. Let's just, you know, state the facts that it's his first match, so he's probably lacking chemistry with the rest of the team. So sometimes that happens, so no problem. You understand him not playing good in this match. Okay, but look, okay, now that looks bad. You mean he kicked the shit out of him, you mean, for no reason. But you go hustle from Balogun, I guess. Now look at that, madre mía, Montes, tío. I have perdido los nervios. Now this is why I say this is unnecessary, because keep in mind, you gotta keep a cool head, man. Even though it's Mexico and there's rivalry and whatever, man, keep a cool head, because we got one more game in order to win this, man. We gotta play against Canada, man, in the final. All this for me is unnecessary, it's uncalled for, man. Why do we have to fight, man? We're winning 2-0, man. They are pissed and they are mad because they're losing 2-0. Us? Why get into this? The announcer said he saw a punch. Madre mía, la camisa de McKinney. Madre mía, his jersey, man. Look at that. Okay, now also, man, that's unnecessary. You mean, that's uncalled for, man. I don't like that. You mean, me? I'm a type of player, right? That I don't like this stuff. You mean, I mean, him bragging like that, you know, against Mexico and so, man. Because, man, estos son rachas. Sometimes, you know, tiene buenas rachas y malas rachas. Now, the thing is that, you know, United States, we're playing very good and we are better. But in the past, it wasn't like that. And maybe in 5 years, who knows? Maybe Mexico's back up top, you know what I mean? So this stuff is uncalled for, you know, from Weston McKennie. I don't like that, man. I don't like that. I don't like disrespecting the opponents like that, man. You got so respect, McKennie, man. I don't like that. I don't like that. I like Weston, but this makes him go down a little bit, you know? I don't like that, man. One thing is doing, you know, kissing your bass, for example, when it's a Clásico and you play Real Madrid versus Barcelona. you've gone, you know, you play all your life for Madrid, you do it, okay. I can more or less understand that, you hear me? But Dale, man, he's not doing it, you know, saying that, you know, he loves, you know, the country or whatever, man. I think he's doing it more as, you know, standard of respect, you hear me? You know, saying that, you know, the United States is far better. Nice steal from Serginho. Okay, Serginho? Man, that pace, dude. Que jugador Serginho, man. Serginho, man, he gotta move to a club, man, where he plays regular football, man. Because I tell you, man, the potential and what he can be, man. Oh my goodness, man. I see, man, I see the best right back in United States men's national team history. And there we go, Ricardo Pepi. Look at that assist from Serginho Dest, man. After flying through the wing. Now, possibly Ricardo Pepi should be the starter, you mean? He's the striker more in form right now. He just scored a goal. He has chemistry with the other guys. Balogun still hasn't had that chemistry. Maybe Balogun should play the Gold Cup, you mean? In order to gain more chemistry. And understand how United States plays. So for me, Ricardo Pepi will be the starter in the next match against Canada. And obviously, in the second half, I will give Balogun some minutes. But this is a very good performance from the United States, man. This is very good. Very good finish from Ricardo Pepi. From the highlights, it seems like Serginho Dest had one hell of a match. Where also, Pepi played really good also. He just scored. Captain America once again played very good. You see, now this is stupidity, man, because Mexico's they're pissed, you mean? They're losing 3-0, man. I understand why they're pissed. You don't want to lose like that against your rivals, man. So, Serginho Dest, man, you gotta understand that they're gonna try to do anything, man, in order to mess you up, you hear me? And make you mess up. And basically this is what they did, you mean? They got you kicked out of the match and now you ain't gonna play against Canada in the final, man. And that puts us in a difficult spot because we don't have no right backs. You hear me? I mean, let me take that back. This could be a good chance for Joe Scully, you hear me, against Canada. Look at this, he pushes from the back, you hear me? Now let's be honest, you know this. Are you gonna fight him? Are you gonna beat him up? No, you ain't gonna do that, you hear me? You ain't like that, you hear me? I mean, Be honest, man, you ain't like players in the 80s. You ain't gonna go and straight up fight him, you know what I mean? So why push him, man? I mean, just stay, you know, remain cool, man. Keep your calm, man. Keep your composure. You see, that was stupid, man. And the ref is right there. I mean, Dest, you're being stupid right here, man. You're being reckless, man. Look at that. Arteaga and Dest wanted to fight, man. They're both fullbacks, eh? Now, you know, Arteaga did what he wanted. He achieved what he wanted, probably. That was to, you know, get Dest sent off. I mean, look at this, man. Right in front of the refs, man. This from Arteaga is understandable, you mean, because he's pissed, he's losing. But this from Serginho Dest, stupid, man. It's reckless. Man, ignore. I mean, man. Now, that you just see that, man? Just threw a cup on Serginho Dest, man. Now, that's also another thing. That's pathetic from fans, man. I mean, come on, man. You're going there to watch a game, to watch, you know, a show, man. Don't take it that seriously, man, in the end of the day, man. Because, I mean, basically, I don't know what to say, man. It's just lamentable, tío, ver eso sobre un aficionado. I mean, madre mía, look at that. Another cup, man, almost hit Pepi in the face, man. Into the discriminatory protocol. If he has stopped the match due to discriminatory chanting, this behavior continues, we will be ejected from the stadium. The match could be suspended or abandoned, and there will be no refunds. Discrimination has no place in football. What the heck happened, man?
por el grito discriminatorio. Después,
man, fans, you just don't know how to behave, eh? It's in the 89th minute, man. What the heck does it matter now, man? Call it off, man. That's in the match. It's the 90th minute. There's no more time for nothing, man. And people don't know how to behave, so simply end them, man. Finish the match. Very harsh, man, with announcing the same, but yes, I mean, that is true. It's a poor performance from Mexico, man. It's a bad look, man. 12 extra minutes, man. Why are you adding 12 extra minutes? That match is finished, man. It's done and dusted. That's 3-0, man. Let's end Mexico's agony, man. We're suffering. Okay, man, match is over, man. Now, the two things I have to say, man. One is, United States, man, the verdict, what they have to try to do now, man, is start scheduling matches, man, against European teams, you know what I mean? You want to face opponents, man, like Poland, Denmark, Sweden. These opponents, that they are basically like dark horses, you know what I mean? They are good, man, but they're not top. Those are the points you want to start trying to face, you know, in order to, you know, keep developing and getting better. Because in the end, when you compete in a World Cup, those are the type of rivals, right, that you're going to face besides the top teams, you know what I mean? So first you got to start, you know, performing against them, and then start, you know, looking at getting matches against, you know, France, Spain, you know, top countries, right? Because if not, man, if we don't do that, man, and we just keep playing, you know, teams in Concacaf, right, this is going to be our level, basically. This is it. What we're doing right now, which is, you know, basically dominating Concacaf, and our best merit, right? Our best, let me take this word one second, man. Our best achievement, okay, our best merit, yes, you can say like that, would be beating Mexico, you know what I mean? That would be our biggest trophy, man. Right now, that's our level right now, you know what I mean? Now, that for me, that's not good enough, man. I mean, you know what? I don't really care much about this tournament, you know what I mean? Yes, it's nice to win it, and yes, I want to see United States win and play good, and so on, man, but the World Cup is everything. That's what matters, you know what I mean? That's what makes our country good, you know what I mean, in the end. And United States so far, man, they're trash in World Cup, so, you know, when I gotta face real opponents, man, that's how it is. And also in Copa America, you know what I mean? Also, I mean, so, basically, that's it, man. That's my verdict about United States. My verdict now about Mexico is, man, that this should be a turning point for you guys, man. You gotta start realizing, man, that you have some issues right now. You got some problems, man, when it comes to your national team. Because, man, it can't be, man, that now that United States is improving, right? And they're growing, right? And, yes, and Canada also, right? So, I would like to see, you know, CONCACAF football to grow as a whole, right? You know, be better, right? As a whole, the continent, right? That's how everyone becomes better, man. You know, and for us to get our respect, the whole continent has to grow and be better. So it can be now, you know, now that Canada and the United States are growing, it can be the time for you, Mexico, to start, you know, downgrading and getting worse, man. That cannot be. I mean, you gotta look at yourself seriously in the mirror, man, and say, what's going on, man? What are the mistakes, you know what I mean? This can happen, man. It can't be, man, like this, man, Mexico, because in the past, man, before, man, you were number one in CONCACAF. You mean, that's not arguable. I mean, that's a fact. You were number one. I always have a lot of respect for Mexico, man. When we face them, I always, a lot of times, I was scared, you mean? Now, not so much, but because your team has gotten way worse, man. Your talent, man, I don't know what happened, man. There's not so many Mexicans now in Europe and stuff like that, man. The development is getting worse, man. And how can that happen, man? From a country like you, man, it's a great country, man. You guys love soccer, man, or football. And you guys are pretty good at it, man. And if we look at the whole history, you guys have been better than the United States. That's a fact, you know what I mean? That's a fact. Now, the thing is, right now, in the 2020s, the United States is better. But from the 2020s back, you know, to the beginning of time, Mexico has always been better. And you guys, man, you can't lose 3-0 against the United States. That's unacceptable, you know what I mean? I mean, you guys should be losing 3-2. If you lose 3-2, yes, that's acceptable, because you fought for it, you know what I mean? There was a fight. You tried, you know what I mean? See, 3-0 seems like you give no effort, man. Basically, that's what I'm saying, you know what I mean? Because I want to see, you know, Mexico, Canada, United States up there, you mean, competing, man. Being, you know, strong teams, man. And it will be United States versus Canada, man, for the finals of the Nation Leagues, man.